Welcome, welcome, welcome everyone to another beautiful Wednesday night. Amen?
Yes,
yeah, so a round of applause for the King of Kings. Praise the Lord. All right, keep the clapping going. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout your joy with the voice of triumph. Clap your hands, all you people. Sing for joy to the Lord. Sing that again. Clap your hands.
Clap your hands, all you people. Shout your God with the voice of triumph.
Clap your hands.
Clap your hands,
all you people.
All you
joy to the Lord.
Sing for joy to the Lord.
We're singing.
We're singing hallelujah, hallelujah. We're singing hallelujah, hallelujah. We're singing hallelujah, hallelujah. We're singing hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus Christ is Lord of all.
Jesus Christ is the Lord of
Lord
all.
Of all.
Joy to the Lord.
We're singing hallelujah.
We're singing hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're singing hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're singing hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're singing hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ is the Lord of all.
Lord of all.
Jesus is Lord of all.
Jesus Christ is Lord of all.
Jesus Christ is the Lord of all. Lord of all the earth. Jesus Christ is the Lord of all. Lord of all the earth. Jesus Christ is the Lord of all. Lord of all the earth. Jesus Christ is the Lord of all. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Another round of applause. Keep that applause going. The mighty God. We sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to you, O God. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah to your name, O mighty God. Indeed, O God, we can sing hallelujah to the one and only true God. You are a mighty God. You're an awesome God. And we come to praise you. We come to join with all of those through the media tonight, wherever you join us from, brothers and sisters, whether it be here in Trinidad and Tobago, whether it be up the islands, whether it be in north, south, east, west of the world, wherever you are. It is just wonderful to have you here praising with us as we sing our hallelujahs to the Lord. And we are going to keep singing those hallelujahs as we keep praising him, because there's nothing greater than just praising our God. And we know that we are set free as we praise our God. We give him permission as we praise his name to do with us whatever he wills. Our praises, just say to the Lord, just take over, Lord Jesus. It's all yours. Praise your name. Praise you, Jesus. Let's bless the Lord. Glory, glory, Lord.
Glory, glory.
We give you glory, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord.
done for us.
See what the Lord has done for us.
See what a mighty
See
God he is.
What a mighty God he is.
See what the Lord has
See
done for us.
See what the Lord has done for
See
us.
See what a mighty God
See
he is.
What a mighty God he is.
Walls are tumbling.
The walls are tumbling. The walls are tumbling. The walls are tumbling. So let's praise his holy name.
Walls are tumbling.
Walls are tumbling. Walls are tumbling. Walls are tumbling. So let's praise
the See what the Lord has done for us.
See what the Lord has done for us.
See what a mighty God he is.
What a mighty God he is.
See what the Lord has done for us.
What the Lord has done for us.
See what a mighty God he is.
What a mighty God he is.
Walls are tumbling.
The walls are tumbling. Walls are tumbling. The walls are tumbling.
So let's praise his holy
so
name.
So let's praise his holy name.
Praise his holy name.
Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. So let's praise his
glory,
name.
Glory, Lord.
Glory, glory, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord. One more time, glory, glory, Lord.
Glory, glory, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord. Glory, glory,
you are a mighty God.
You are a mighty
You are an awesome God.
You are an awesome God.
We give you glory.
We give you glory, Lord.
Praise your name, O God.
We give you glory, O Lord.
Thank you,
O
God.
Thank
you, Jesus. Indeed, brothers and sisters, we sing and we pray and we shout hallelujah to our God, because he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He's a mighty God and an awesome God. And it is that very same God who is in our midst right now. Because as we, the people of God, gather and we call upon his name, as we invite his Holy Spirit to come, our God comes. He comes in all humility. He comes in glory. He comes to pour out his healing upon us. He comes to touch us. This is our God, the one who saves, the one who has redeemed each one of us and called us by name. He is the one who is present here right now. How privileged we are to know that God is here with us, that we can reach out and touch him, that he moves amongst us, touching each one of us. And Lord, we pray that indeed, that as you pour out your Holy Spirit on us, that Lord, you would just cause us, Lord, to truly worship you with everything that we are. We pray that you might set us free, O God, set our bodies free, our hands free, our mouths and our tongues free, to praise you and to worship you. And as you pour out your Spirit, O God, we know that you will even give us the very words with which to praise you, for that is the God that you are. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for all that you are doing here now, O God. And truly, Lord, we surrender ourselves to you. We give you everything that we are, O God, that we might become instruments of praise. We bless you, we praise you, and we thank
you.
Holy are you, O God, and worthy, worthy, worthy to be praised. You who are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we exalt you, O God, in our midst. Pour out your blessing, O God. Pour out your blessing on us.
Here comes the wind.
Here comes the wind.
Here comes the fire.
Here comes the fire.
It's the Holy Spirit.
It's the Holy Spirit.
Moving all over.
Moving all over.
Blow wind, blow.
Blow wind, blow.
Burn, fire, burn.
Burn, fire, burn.
Let your anointing
go. Let your anointing go. Let your anointing
go. Here comes the wind.
Here comes the fire.
It's the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Spirit
moving all over.
Moving all
Come with your fire to set our hearts ablaze, and we will see your glory as we worship in this place. Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit. Come, O Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit.
Be with us today. Come with your fire to set our hearts ablaze, and we will see your glory as we worship in this place. Here comes the wind.
Here comes the wind.
Here comes the fire.
Here comes the fire.
It's the Holy Spirit.
It's the Holy Spirit.
Moving all over.
Moving all over.
Blow and blow.
Blow and blow.
Burn fire, burn.
Burn fire, burn.
Let your anointing
pour. Let your
pour.
Anointing pour. Let your anointing pour. Here comes the wind.
It's good for us to be here. Amen. Amen. What about our sisters and brothers who join us? Isn't it good for them to be here with us too? Let's give them a round of applause. Welcome, sisters and brothers. What kind of week we had? Great. Blessed.
Graceful.
Graceful. Spirit-filled. Nobody catches week or not? Huh? Nobody catch this week? You didn't find it was a hard week? Nobody? Wonder if anybody at home found it was a difficult week? Yeah, we had some people that found it. Yes. Everything was great. Dow, you had a good week? Great week. Well, praise the Lord for that. But I have a feeling a few people had not such a good week. Somehow I just feel so. Maybe, what? Why we didn't have such a good week? What it is that could really upset us? I think it's we ourselves. Don't we get upset with our own selves? We weren't so nice all the time. Isn't that right? We weren't so good. We got vexed. Maybe we got vexed with the children or the husband or the wife or the person in the road. Maybe we just, you're getting closer now, huh? Okay, we're getting a little closer now. We were not the people that we were not the best that we could be. You don't think so? We strive to be the best we could be. We want to be the best we could be because we'd be more like Jesus if we were the best. But we fall short of that. Amen?
Amen.
You know, it's very good to recognize that we fall short. Let's just ask God for forgiveness as we begin tonight. Let's ask Him for forgiveness for the times this week that we were not the best that we could be. Just bring to mind maybe any situation, any encounter that you had, any time that you know the Lord was asking something more of you and you just couldn't happen. Just recognize your own weakness, our own weakness and sinfulness. And know that this God is an amazing, loving, and merciful God. And He wants sisters and brothers just to pour out His grace, His mercy upon us tonight. So that we could leave behind the sadness and the bundles of the week and move on in grace and glory with our God. weakness, Lord. We want to be more like you. Just as we surrender these times for our week, Lord, we are sorry, Lord. And if we have hurt anyone, oh God, we ask, Lord, that you yourself will touch that person right now. Might be someone in our own homes, our husband, our wives, our children, mother, father. Might be somebody that we worked with or somebody we just met casually on the street and we just were not nice. We recognize, Lord, that we are in need of your grace and mercy tonight. Pour out that grace upon us and free us, Lord. Set us free of the ways that we have not been what you would have asked us to be this week. Change our hearts indeed that always we may be filled with your grace and desired from deep within, Lord, to be the people that you ask us to be. Change my heart, O God.
Change my heart, O Lord.
May I be like you.
May I be like you.
Let's sing that again. Change my heart, O Lord.
Change my heart, O Lord.
Make it ever true.
Make it ever true. You are the potter.
I am the clay.
I am the clay.
Mold me and make me.
Mold me and make me.
This is what I pray.
This is what I pray.
Change my heart, O Lord.
Change my heart, O Lord.
Make it ever true.
Make it ever true. Change my heart, O Lord.
May I be like you.
May I be like you.
If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but I'm without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Lord, the only way that we can change and become what you want us to be is with love. And so, Lord, we pray that you may pour your love into our hearts so that we may love in that all-consuming, all-transforming love. Lord, that indeed we may be patient and be willing to endure whatever is difficult in our lives, that we may be kind and gentle and loving to those close to us and those whom we meet. That, Lord, we may see ourselves in all humility as we truly are before you, and allow to fall away from us all that is inflated, all that is fills us with conceit, where we think that we are better than anyone else. Lord, where we boast of our own achievements, Lord, may we let all that go. May we always, Lord, speak with kindness and goodness and courtesy to others, and not be rude, not put others down, but lift them up. Lord, we know our hearts, and we know how incapable we are of all that. But you are love, O God, and you share with us your very life, which is love. So, Lord, tonight, may your love be upon us. May your love fill us and burn within us, burning away all the dross, all the ugliness, which is sin in our lives.
Make it ever true.
Change my heart, O Lord.
Change my heart, O Lord.
May I be like you.
May I be like you.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord God. Oh, yes, Lord, move, let your heart move within us tonight. Praise you, Lord. We praise the Lord as he sets us free, as he releases our sisters and brothers. He sets us free so that we can praise him indeed. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you for your spirit. Thank you for your forgiveness, O God. Thank you for your love and your healing, Lord, as we surrender all to you in praise and thanksgiving tonight. Glory to you, O Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. You're a forgiving God, a merciful God. You're a God who is so filled with mercy, Lord. Thank you for sending your mercy upon us tonight, O God. Blessed be the Lord. Blessed be you, O God. We praise you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's have a round of applause for this God. Praise the Lord. And you know, when the Lord forgives us, he gives us a hug. Hug the person next to you. You know, you have the Lord in you. We have the Lord in us. So for Jesus, let's hug each other. And those of you who join us, let's hug each other tonight in the freedom of Jesus, in the freedom of the power of God's love.
Washed by the blood of the Lamb.
Washed by the blood of the Lamb.
Clothed in your righteousness.
Clothed in your righteousness.
And in your favor we stand.
And in your favor we stand.
We love exalting your name.
We love exalting your
name. Lifting up holy hands.
Lifting up holy hands.
Praise to Almighty God.
Praise to Almighty
oh,
God.
Oh, what a great I am.
Oh, what a great I am.
The God of our salvation.
Let there be singing and shouting,
dancing and celebration.
Dancing and celebration. Children of Zion, rejoice.
We are your people, O God.
We are your people.
washed by the blood of the Lamb.
Washed by the blood of the Lamb.
Clothed in your righteousness.
Clothed in your righteousness.
And in your favor we stand.
And in your favor we stand.
We love exalting your name.
We love exalting your name.
Lifting up holy hands.
Lifting up holy hands.
Praise to Almighty God.
Praise to
what a great I am.
Oh, what a great I am.
Let there be joy in the house
Let
of the Lord.
Let there be joy in the house of the Lord.
Let there be praise to the God of
Let
our salvation.
To the God of our salvation.
Let there be singing and shouting.
Let there be singing
dancing
and shouting.
And celebration.
Dancing and celebration.
Children of Zion,
Children
rejoice.
Of Zion,
Let there be joy in the house of the
Let
Lord.
Let there be joy in the house of the
Let
Lord.
There be praise to the God of our
Let
salvation.
Praise to the God of our salvation.
Let there be singing and shouting.
Let there be singing and
dancing
shouting.
And celebration.
Dancing and celebration.
Children of
Zion,
Children
rejoice. Of Zion rejoice. Children of Zion, rejoice. Children of Zion, rejoice.
We are your people, O Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Our Lord God, even as we say it so easily, O Lord, we recognize, Lord, the privilege, the blessing, O Lord God, to be called your people. For Lord, it is you who have called us your people. It is you who have called, you who have invited, you who have made it possible, Lord. We are your people. And Lord, even as we think of all that this means, O Lord, our minds are too small to grasp the immensity, O Lord, of this call. The immensity of the love behind the call, O Lord God. We are your people. Lord, we who stand here, those of our brothers and sisters who join us through the media, people called by your name throughout the world, we are your people, O Lord God. And Lord, we are the people who have received your mercy. We are the people you've looked on in compassion. We are the people, Lord, you've poured out your forgiveness on, O Lord God. And we are the people you protect and provide for, O Lord God. We are your people. And Lord God, as we rejoice in that tonight, as we rejoice in your call, as we rejoice, O Lord God, in your love, bring us, Lord, through the power of your Spirit and a deeper and deeper recognition of all that it means, so that in this world you may have a people, Lord God, a true and a faithful people, that in this world, in this country, O Lord God, and wherever our brothers and sisters are who join us through the media, Lord, that right there, your people may shine like bright stars because we are offering, Lord, you to the world, O Lord God. We bless you, Lord. We praise your name, O Lord God. And we thank you, Lord, for this tremendous privilege of being called your people. We praise you, Lord, and we bless you. We thank you, Lord God.
Let there be glory and honor.
Glory and honor and praises. Glory and honor
to Jesus.
To Jesus.
Glory.
Glory.
And honor.
And honor.
Glory and honor to him. Let there be glory and honor.
Let there be glory and honor
and praise. Glory and honor to Jesus.
Glory and honor to Jesus.
Glory.
Glory.
And honor.
And honor.
Glory and honor to him. One more time.
Let there be glory.
Let's tell the whole of Port of Spain.
And praises.
Glory and honor to Jesus.
Glory and honor to Jesus.
Glory.
Glory.
And honor.
And honor.
Glory and honor to him.
Glory and honor to him.
Indeed, sisters and brothers, we are called to glorify the Lord, to praise our God, to lift our voices rejoicing.
Yes, Lord.
Earlier we sang, change our hearts, O God. And we know from the scriptures that Jesus says it is their hardness of heart that prevented them from living in the will of the Lord. Tonight, we have asked the Lord to work within us, to remove that hardness of heart, so that we may truly live in His will, so that we may truly rejoice in the Lord, so that we may truly be fully His. Let us allow the Lord to have His way. Let us allow the Lord to be God. Let us allow the Lord to be Lord and Master of our lives. We praise you, O God. We bless you. We worship and glorify you, O God. Praise you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, O God. Praise you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord.
Majesty, worship His Majesty,
worship His Majesty.
Unto Jesus,
unto Jesus be glory, honor, and praise.
Majesty,
Majesty,
King of authority,
King of authority,
forth from His throne,
forth from His
unto
throne,
His own,
unto
His
own,
anthems raise.
His anthems raise.
So exalt,
so
lift,
exalt
up on high,
lift up on
the
high,
name of Jesus,
the name of Jesus,
magnify,
magnify,
come glorify,
come glorify,
Christ Jesus our King,
Jesus our King,
Majesty,
Majesty,
worship His Majesty,
worship His Majesty,
Jesus who died,
Jesus who died,
now glorified,
now glorified,
King of all
King
kings.
Of all
up on high,
lift up on high,
the name of
the
Jesus,
name of Jesus,
magnify,
magnify,
come glorify,
come glorify,
Christ Jesus our King,
Jesus our King,
Majesty,
Majesty,
worship His Majesty,
worship His Majesty,
Jesus who died,
Jesus who died,
now glorified,
now glorified,
King of all kings,
King of all kings,
Jesus who died,
Jesus who died, now glorified, King of all kings.
Ishari ala ri ala ri ala ma, keri ala ri ala ishan ala ri ala ma, iri ala iteri ala ri ala ma, kishan ala ri ala ma ishan ala ma. Let's just praise God in our beautiful gift of tongues tonight, brothers and sisters. Lift your hands, lift your voices, let your whole beings just acclaim Him as King and Lord and God tonight. Brothers and sisters, through the media, join us in praising God. Let praise just resound throughout this land, throughout the nation, throughout the islands, throughout the world. May our praises be like incense before the throne of God tonight, touching the heart of God.
Glory, praise to you, Lord, holy, holy, mighty God. Bless your name, glory, glory, Lord. Ishana la ri ala ri ala ma, kiri ala ri ala ishana la ri ala ma, iri ala ishana la ri ala ma.
Oh, what beautiful power there is in praise, brothers and sisters. We know, we experience that as we praise our God, that our souls are just lifted to Him. So much tension that we carry is just moved away. Any stress that we are carrying, any healing that we need as we praise our God, we just are assured of God just lifting all of that and just setting us free. Such beautiful power in praise, brothers and sisters. Let us never grow tired or weary of praising our God. Just let us utter praise to Him tonight. We bless you, Lord. Bless you, Jesus. Glory, glory to you, Almighty God. We just want to praise you. Let's praise Him with our voices, brothers and sisters. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus.
Light of the world.
Light of
you step down into darkness.
He sat down into darkness.
Opened my eyes.
Opened
let
my
me
eyes.
See.
Let me see.
Beauty that made this heart adore
beauty
you.
Beauty that made this heart adore
hope of a life spent with
hope
you.
Hope of a life spent with you.
Here I am to worship.
Here I am to worship.
Here I am to bow down.
Here I am to bow down.
Here I am to say that you're my God.
Here I am to say that you're my God.
You're altogether lovely.
You're altogether lovely.
Altogether worthy.
Altogether worthy.
Altogether wonderful to me.
Altogether
of all days.
King of all
oh, so highly
days,
exalted,
so highly
glorious
exalted,
in heaven above.
Glorious in heaven above.
Humbly you came to the earth you created.
Humbly you came to the earth you created.
All for love's sake became poor.
All for love's sake.
To worship.
Here I am to worship.
Here I am to bow down.
Here I am to bow down.
Here I am to say you're my God.
Here I am to say that you're my God.
You're altogether lovely.
You're altogether
lovely. Altogether worthy.
Altogether worthy.
Altogether wonderful to me.
Altogether wonderful.
To worship.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God.
You're altogether lovely.
You're altogether lovely.
Altogether worthy.
Altogether worthy.
Altogether wonderful to me.
Altogether wonderful to me.
We bow in your presence, O God. This is holy ground. This is holy ground, brothers and sisters. For the Lord is present, and where He is holy.
Just in a moment of silence, let us just stand in that holy presence, knowing that our God is here. Experience His touch upon your life. Experience the power of His Spirit going into the depths of your soul. This is a holy moment of grace.
Standing on holy ground.
We're standing on holy ground.
For the Lord is present.
For the Lord is present.
And where He is.
And where He is.
Is holy.
Is holy.
This is holy ground.
This is holy ground.
Standing on holy ground.
We're standing on holy ground.
For the Lord is present.
For the Lord is present.
And where He is.
And where He is. Is holy.
This is holy.
Standing on holy ground.
For the Lord is present.
For the Lord is present.
And where He is.
And where He is.
Is holy.
Is holy. This is holy ground. We're standing.
Shalala, yala, be, shalala, be, yala, 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 be, yala
Bless you, Jesus. Praise your name, O God. Praise you, Jesus. In the power of your grace, come, Lord. Let your healing flow, O God. Let your power just be ever present, O God. Just touching hearts and healing your people. Ministering to each one, O Lord God. As you are present in this holy place, O God. In this holy ground, O God. Just do a mighty work in the hearts and the lives of your people tonight, O Jesus. Thank you, O God. Thank you for all that you do here in our midst, O Lord Jesus. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Just allow the Lord just to heal you tonight, brothers and sisters. Let him just touch you with his mighty love tonight. Let him minister unto you. Just open your hearts, open your hands, just to receive of his grace being poured out in abundance in this place tonight. Just receive from your God. He loves you. He desires to heal you. He desires to transform you. Allow his grace just to be poured out tonight. Receive from the Lord. Just receive. Receive the abundance of his love. Receive from your God. This mighty God. This mighty God that came down to touch our lives with his love. That left his throne in heaven to come and be one with us. That he may love us into wholeness. That he may love us into renewing our lives. Taking away our sin and planting his love instead and his forgiveness and his mercy. Taking away all that is broken and wounded and replacing it with his healing mercy, his healing compassion, his healing love. Just receive from the Lord tonight. Just receive from the Lord. We bless you, Lord God. Bless your name, holy, holy God. Shana la di ala me, shana la di ala di ala me, kiri ala I shala me di ala me, teni ala I teni ala di ala di ala me, I shala la di ala me, teni ala di ala di ala di ala me. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, God. Bless you, Lord. Bless your name. Let's just sit as we just continue to be in the presence of our God, this God who loves. And this God who is here moving in this place that also longs to speak his word to us, to whisper into the depths of our hearts. Let us be attentive to his voice. Speak, Lord, as we, your servants, listen to you.
My beloved children, my beloved people, tonight you say that you are standing on holy ground, and indeed you are standing on holy ground. And tonight I say to you that I am going to make this complete land, from the north to the south, to the east to the west, the hills of Lavanti, the plains of Karani, every area in this country, my beloved, I am going to sanctify and make holy ground. My beloved, you are called to spread my word. You are called to go out. You are called to show people new life with me. And as you go, I sanctify. As you move out, I bless. As you go out, my beloved, I make this land holy ground.
Indeed, my people, you are here at the beginning of the river that will flow over this land. I want you to realize that as you leave this room, this place, you leave like the stream that will flow over this land. so that wherever you go, it is by your witness and by your life that others will be touched. It is my desire, my people, that you will grow to be the witness of love, the witness of truth, and that you would radiate and reflect the very brightness of your God. And yes, in this holy place, I desire to say to you, I have given to you much in the sacraments, and I ask that you will reflect on them. I ask that you will eat of my body and blood. I ask that you will come and meet me in the holy sacrament of reconciliation. I ask that when you go to weddings, you recognize and believe the very gift of that sanctifying grace upon that couple, that you intercede and pray that they may be holy, so that this land will become holy, so that their children will be holy. I desire, my people, that in this place, from this place where you move, that when you visit the sick, you pray with them, but recognize also that there is a need for the sacrament of the sick. And when one is dying, never forget to call the anointed priest that could anoint the dying child of God. I say to you, my beloved, even when you bring your child to the altar in baptism, when you go with your grandchildren, when you go with your own infant child, recognize the privilege in that holy sacrament. It is my desire that you become a holy people, that this nation become a holy nation, that the people of God in this land will be the witness to the world. Haven't I not said this to you? And this is why I ask you to feed yourself on the gifts of the sacraments that I have given to you. Not to live frivolous lives just for today, but live your lives for your brother and your sister. Live your lives for the dying and the sick. Live your lives for the broken and the wounded. Live your lives for the sinner who is in need of healing and of reconciliation with me. I say to you, behold, in the sacraments you can receive the sanctifying grace of your God. But you must live holy lives, and you must not live lives that are frivolous. I say to you, my beloved, remember that the eyes of the world are upon you, and so you cannot fool the world, but live simply and humbly, rich in love and full of mercy, so that the world will receive the message that I offer through you, my beloved people. Each one of you make up this river that flows to whatever nation you go and wherever I send you. But always, always prepare, as I prepared in contemplating you, even before the world was made, I contemplated you, my child, and I contemplated the choice and the purpose for which I created you. And this is why I say to you, work well together to come to fulfill the perfect purpose of my wonderful plan.
Praise God. Just thank God for the gift of the prophecy and word tonight. Bless God for that.
Thy word unto my heart.
Bless thy word unto my heart.
And glorify thy name.
And glorify thy name.
No. glorify thy name.
Glorify.
Unto my heart.
Thy word unto my heart.
Glorify thy name.
Glorify thy name.
The first prophecy tonight spoke to us, the Lord spoke to us about the blessing of this land. From north and south and east and west, from the hills and the plains. And he spoke to us of the sacraments, which is, to me, the river of grace being poured out upon us. And confirming that word from Psalm 46, there is a river whose streams refresh the city of God, and it sanctifies the dwelling of the Most High. God is inside the city, she can never fall. At crack of dawn, God helps her. To the roaring of nations and tottering of kingdoms, when he shouts, the world disintegrates. But Yahweh Sabaoth is on our side, our citadel, the God of Jacob. Praise God. Anyone else would like to share the scriptures tonight to confirm the word? Confirm.
This is taken from Ephesians 1. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all the spiritual blessings of heaven in Christ. Before the world was made, he chose us in Christ to be holy and spotless and to live through love in his presence, determining that we should become his adopted sons through Jesus Christ for his own kind purposes, to make us praise the glory of his grace, his free gift to us in the Beloved, in whom through his blood we gain our freedom, the forgiveness of our sins. Such is the richness of the grace which he has showered on us in all wisdom and insight. He has let us know the mystery of his purpose, the hidden plan he so kindly made in Christ from the beginning, to act upon when the times has run their course to the end, that he would bring everything together under Christ as head, everything in the heavens and everything on earth. And it is in him that we were claimed as God's own, chosen from the beginning, under the predetermined plan of the one who guides all things.
Two passages from Ephesians, and one just a continuation of what Anne was reading, that we have chosen to be for his greater glory. The people would put their hopes in Christ before he came. Now you too in him have heard the message of the truth and the good news of your salvation and have believed it. You too have been stamped with the seal of the Holy Spirit of the promise, the pledge of our inheritance. You are part of a building that has the apostles and prophets for its foundations. Christ Jesus himself its cornerstone. Every structure is aligned on him, all growing to one holy temple in the Lord. You too in him are being built into a house where God lives in the Spirit. We know the passage, John 10:10, right? What does it say?
I've come that they may have life and have it to the full. I have come that... Who is this thee? Us. I agree with that, but I think it's a step two. God, the Lord has come that we might have life. But why? Not just to stop there. As the Lord says in the prophet Isaiah, it is not enough for you to be my people. I make you the light to the nations, a covenant to the peoples. So that I've come that they may have life and have it to the full. So we are the they. The Lord has come that we might have life, but only so that the whole world might have life. The world might be transformed. You know, Jesus is not a person. You know, as we heard in Ephesians 1, God had a plan from before all time. Even before there was creation, God had a plan. God is not a person of a small mind. You know, long brain is not the word. You know, God I fail for words, not because of the greatness of God, but the smallest of my brain right now. But anyway, it kind of closes up a little bit more. Finally, the older I get, the earlier my brain goes to sleep. So anyway, what was I saying? What was I saying? That God is about, God has this plan. But it's not a little plan. We make little plans sometimes. But God has a vast plan because God is vast. And what God is about is the transformation of the world. Not just us, not just me, not just you. That's part of it. And sometimes, you know, our minds are small and we can only begin to grasp that the Lord wants me to have the Lord as my personal Savior, full stop. But God is about far more than that. God's mind is larger. God's plan is bigger. And that plan is that the whole universe will come back to the harmony with God that God had planned from the beginning of time. And that man and woman in Adam and Eve rejected. That God, this is the plan. That everything would be united in Christ. And that he would be the head of everything. And for this to happen, for this transformation to come about of the whole universe, God has called a people. And we are that people. And for the people to journey and to bring about this transformation, the Lord feeds us. And the Lord feeds us in many ways. The Lord feeds us with the Bible, there it is. God feeds us with his, and there it is too. The Lord feeds us with the word. And the Lord feeds us through the sacraments. The gift of his body and blood, the gift of his grace and mercy and healing. The Lord feeds us. And once again, not just for my own individual journey to the Lord. It is not enough for you to be my servant, but I make you the light of the nations, covenant to all the peoples. And this is who we are. You know, the people of God called for a reason. And that reason is that the world, the universe might be transformed and might come back to that original harmony. That's God's plan. The plan he had from the very beginning, as we heard the one Ephesians 1 telling us. You know, and we ask the Lord to expand our minds, our hearts, that it may have room for everybody. And a room to recognize that the call is not just about me and me alone. You know, sometimes, well, we do have sometimes a kind of, well, it's natural, I suppose, because of who we are, limited human beings and so on. Sometimes we are praying. And, you know, our minds can only conceive of my problem. You know, and I might think, oh, God, I have this problem, and I need to pray for it, and so on, and so on, and so on. But the heart of God, the plan of God is so vast that there's room for everybody's problem. And so even as I'm praying for my problem, you know, one way of expanding my consciousness in that way is that to bring everybody who has the same problem before God. So I'm praying, I have this, well, maybe an alcoholic spouse, maybe I'm dealing with a diagnosis of some sickness or the other, you know, and I'm praying about this. But expand the prayer and bring it to the heart of God, not just my diagnosis, but all those throughout the world who are experiencing the same thing. And in that little way too, you know, we begin to see that the plan of God is so vast, the heart of God so huge. We cannot even begin to imagine this mystery that God had hidden from the very beginning. We can't even begin to imagine it. But there it is. From the moment, as it were, from the moment of the rejection in the Garden of Eden, God has his plan. I will restore. I will bring back harmony. I will reconcile again. And what the whole story of the Bible is at work. Of God's working to restore, working to bring back harmony. And Jesus, of course, comes to do it through his cross and resurrection. And then says, okay, you all carry on now. Carry on my work. And here we are 2,000 years later. Part of the people called to carry on the work. Each one of us. And you know, maybe you're at home and you can't go anywhere and you feel, well, what can I do? And you have a very important role of interceding, of praying for the plan of God to come about. A very important role of maybe offering your sufferings to the Lord as part of your prayer, that this transformation would come about. There's a prayer in Eucharist. There's one of the prayers in Eucharistic Prayer 3. That God might advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Saying, well, Lord, I don't know if you're hearing this prayer or not. The world don't look like it's advancing too far. But we know that somehow God is at work. That even with my human eyes, I can't see that this advancing, and the world seems actually to be, what's the opposite of advancing? Regressing. Retreating. Is that enough word? Regressing. Okay, praise God. Sounds more intelligent. Right. The world is regressing. But yet we know that God is at work because his plan of God is unfolding, because it's God's plan. And yes, we may slow it down by sin. We slow it down. But it is God's plan and it will be. And one day we come to that tremendous day when the Lord comes again and everything is transformed. And that perfect harmony that God has planned from the beginning will be there throughout the universe. And God asks us to to play a part in that happening. And we are the people in this time, in this place, and wherever you are joining us from, the people in that place, the people in this place who God calls at this time to work with him and to be part of that river of grace flowing through the world. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Beautiful word from the Lord tonight, and beautiful sharing by Father Mike. That's how we're going to respond in a song. Let's stand and praise God.
It only takes a spark.
It only takes a spark
to get the fire going.
And soon all those around
can warm up in its glowing. That's how it is with God's love.
That's how it is with God's love.
Once you've experienced it,
you'll
spread his love to everyone. You want to pass it on.
You want to pass it on.
I wish for you, my friend.
I wish for you, my friend.
This happiness that I've found.
This happiness that I've found.
You can depend on him.
You can depend on him.
It matters not where you're bound.
It matters not.
Shout it from the mountaintop.
I shout it from the mountaintop.
I want the world to know.
I want the world.
The Lord of love has come to me.
The Lord of love has come.
I want to pass it on.
I want to pass it on.
I shout it from the mountaintop.
I shout it from the mountaintop.
I want the world to know.
The Lord of love has come to me.
I want to pass it on.
I want to pass it on.
Praise the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. Praise God, sisters and brothers. Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord another round of applause. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now, the word tonight was very beautiful. Amen?
Amen.
And, you know, the word follows and follows and follows every week. 2 weeks ago, we stood right here, and the Lord spoke a word to us about the world. Didn't he? We remember that?
Yes.
The Lord spoke and said to us that he wanted us, and all of you who join us in the media, he wanted us to pray for the world. Because, as Father Mike said, what God wants is the whole world to have life, this tremendous life. He wants to renew the whole world. And he has called us to be a part of this, sisters and brothers, by praying for the world. And the Lord showed us that he would want all of us to pray 1 minute a day for one country in the world. Choose a country, the Lord said. Take up your map, take up your atlas, and look at the world. Choose a country, or the Lord himself will give you the name of a country. And pray for 1 minute every day. 1 minute. That's not too much to pray for our world. Amen? Not at all. So we want, sisters and brothers, to encourage people to pray. I know that all of us here have been praying. Amen?
Amen.
Look at all the pins on where we have prayed. And if you haven't come up yet this evening and you have prayed for a different country, please come and put your pin there. And we want to start this too on social media. We want to start this on Facebook. So we encourage all of you to go onto Facebook. We're going to be posting a map like this, and we're going to be talking about it. We want you to share it. We want you to show it to your people, speak about it, and get people to pray for 1 minute a day for the world. That's not too much. That's not too much, sisters and brothers, that all of us could pray for 1 minute a day for our country in the world. Imagine if we had thousands and thousands and thousands of people doing this. This is what God is asking. That's what he wants. A river flowing from here. A river flowing from here. And flowing, sisters and brothers, those of you who are through the media, can join in and pray with us for this tremendous work of God, renewing the face of the earth. And he's asking us to help him in this. Praise God.
Praise
so, sisters and brothers, let's make a commitment. Not only, as Father Mike says, not only we receive that fullness and that grace, and not only do we pray, we encourage others and we go out. So let's have a tsunami of prayer for our world. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We thank God. So join us. And don't forget, go on to Facebook. Share with your people. Comment, and let's have a good buzz about praying for the world. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's just join hands and ask the Lord to come. Yeah, look at one of the things that will be up on Facebook. It's right here for us to see and for you all at home to see as well. Praise the Lord.
Oh, Lord, you have called us to be at the source of that river of grace that you want to pour out on the whole world. We pray that right now, O God, that you would just fill us with that grace, that you would fill us, Lord, to overflowing with your Holy Spirit, that indeed as each one of us, as we leave here tonight, as we go to our homes and our workplaces, that we might carry your grace and your mercy, your love and your peace to everyone that we would meet. And so we would see our homes, our nation, and our world transformed. We praise you and we bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
In this holiday time, we want to pray for our young people on holiday. Lord, that they may just not be idle and get into any mischief, but Lord, it may be a time where they will encounter you in some way, and that they will be able to share your love with each other and with their friends, and that they will find you, O God. And let it be a special time for our young people. Protect them, O God, from all that is out there that is so tempting and seeking to draw them away from you. Lord, surround them and be close to them and draw them to your heart. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
And for all that's in our hearts tonight, we pray special anointing and blessing, especially for those who may be sick, those who are just struggling today, those who are depressed, lonely, those who need that grace from God, even now as we pray, those who are in need of healing, body, mind, and spirit, O God. Tonight, O God, touch and heal and hear the cry of your people. And we pray for our whole world, O Lord. Come, renew the face of the earth. Come, O Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in us the fire of your love. Send forth your spirit and we shall be recreated and you shall renew the face of the earth. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I think we have a couple of people here for the first time tonight. Can we just see where you are so that we can just welcome you? And praise the Lord. We have a sister there. We have a brother down in the back. He's not putting up his hand, but I know he's here for the first time. Welcome, brother. If there's anyone else, it's always wonderful to have you join us. Thank you so much. And our two young boys on the drums tonight with their dad. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Our young people are alive and well. Amen. Praise the Lord. I don't know if there's any announcement. That's it.
I just want to tell people from now, next month is August, and August the 15th is the Feast of the Assumption of Our Blessed Mother. And normally, and hopefully next month too, we will do a procession around the Savannah. Okay, so let's keep that date ready, posted up right now on your fridge so you remember. Next month, Feast of the Assumption, round the Savannah. But you'll be hearing more about it. Praise the Lord.
Send us out to proclaim the reign of your King.
Send us out to proclaim and to heal.
Send us out to proclaim and to heal.
Send us out with your power
Send
and with your authority.
With your power and your authority.
To overcome.
To overcome.
And to heal the world. Send us out.
Send us out.
To proclaim the reign of your kingdom.
Proclaim the reign of your kingdom.
Send us out to proclaim and to heal.
Send us out. To proclaim and to heal.
Send us out with your power and with
Send
your authority.
Us out with your power and your authority.
To overcome.
To overcome.
And to heal.
To overcome
and to heal.